Hello everyone, this is Monica Lupion and today's presentation is the second part of the lecture, Convective Heat Transfer. This is part of the online course CE 318, Heat and Mass Transfer. In previous presentation, we covered the fundamentals in convection, the difference between natural and forced convection, as well as the definition of a few parameters that would be very useful for the convective heat transfer coefficient evaluation. Then we started to study the different methodologies to evaluate the convective heat transfer. We covered already the dimensional analysis of convective heat transfer, and today the starting point is the exact analysis of the boundary layer. Then we'll follow with the approximate integral analysis, and finally the analogy between momentum and transfer. In addition to these four methodologies to evaluate the convective heat transfer coefficient, we will see in the next lecture that there are also some empirical equations that we can use, and the calculations related to those empirical equations are normally easier than when it comes to the resolution, to the analytical resolution of the heat transfer equations. Okay, let's begin with the exact analysis. What we're gonna do here, it's similar to what you study when the analysis of the momentum transfer. We consider that there is a very thin layer that is very close to the boundary of the body, and within that layer, this will be the profile of the temperature. In the case of the momentum transfer, instead of having a profile of temperature, the analysis included a profile of velocity. The equations that we solved for the momentum transfer that you cover in CE 317 is this one here. And we can see the similarities between the viscous flow and the heat transfer. One of the things is, for instance, the value of the momentum diffusivity and the value of the thermal diffusivity. So we can apply a few conditions in order to use the solutions that we already know from the momentum transfer. Things that we need to take into account is, in the first place, that the momentum viscosity shall be equal to the thermal diffusivity. So then we can apply directly the solutions that we got from the momentum transfer. If you remember from the Prandtl number definition, the Prandtl number is the ratio between the momentum viscosity and the thermal diffusivity. So if the momentum viscosity needs to be equal to the thermal diffusivity alpha, that implies that the Prandtl number has to be 1. So this is one of the first conditions that we need to impose. The second condition is that whatever the boundary conditions we were using here in the momentum transfer solution, we need to find similar or compatible boundary conditions for the heat transfer problem. From the study of the momentum transfer, we defined the solution proposed by Plesius. You have here two different functions, f and eta, and that would be the solution of this equation. So how can we use this solution in the case of heat transfer? So we need to impose a Prandtl number is equal to 1, and we need to impose as well compatible boundary conditions. If we do that, we will get these two functions here that I will further develop. So applying Plesius and doing some calculations, you can take a look to your book in chapter 19. We get to this expression here that relate the temperature and the Reynolds number. Then we apply Newton for the case of convection and Fourier for the case of conduction. In the over the surface of the boundary, the heat that it's reaching the surface through conduction needs to be equal to the heat rate leaving the surface due to convection. So this is exactly what is expressed here in this equation. If we combine this first equation with this second equation, we can define the value of the heat transfer coefficient, the local heat transfer coefficient, related to the Reynolds number. So this is the compact expression here. If we multiply by x, which is the dimension and the thermal conductivity, we can identify this as the local Nusselt number. This problem or this solution has a few limitations. First is the geometry that I haven't talked about it, but this kind of solution can only be applied to a flat plate. And second, that we discussed, is that the Prandtl number has to be 1. Polhausen studied the same problem, but considering the additional effect of having a Prandtl number different than 1. He defined, or he was able to define the Prandtl number in relation to the thickness of the hydrodynamic boundary layer and the thickness of the thermal boundary layer. And he introduced this Prandtl number in the previous equation, and this is the final result. So in case of having a flat plate, no matter what the Prandtl number is, this is the expression that we can use to calculate the local Nusselt number. And once we have the local Nusselt number, we can directly have the heat master coefficient number, the local convective coefficient number. So let's apply this equation to a plate with dimensions y and l. These are the two equations that we just saw. This is the expression proposed by Polhausen, and this is the Newton's law of cooling. So combining these two equations and making the integration here, we can directly have the Nusselt number, the mean heat transfer coefficient, using the Nusselt number or the mean Nusselt number. So this is the expression here that you can directly use when there is a case of a flat plate. And once you know that, you can calculate the Reynolds number, the Prandtl number, and then directly you will have the Nusselt number. And with that, you can directly get the heat transfer coefficient. But again, this is a very limited case when there is a very specific geometry. If we don't have a flat plate, then we can't use this expression here. The fluid properties are usually evaluated in all these equations at the film temperature. And the film temperature is the average between the wall temperature over the boundary and the bulk temperature, which is the T infinity. Let's now take a look to the approximate integral analysis. As I mentioned, the exact analysis is nice when we have a flat surface and laminar flow, but it's very limited due to the fact that it's only applied to a very specific geometry. What happens if we have a completely different geometry or if we don't have a laminar flow? This is the integral analysis used by von Karman. Is taking the solution from the hydrodynamic boundary layer study that you can take a look in chapter number 12 in your textbook. We're not going to go through the different details, But basically, when you apply this methodology proposed by von Karman, this is the final expression that you can get relating the local nusel and the renal and the pram. The last methodology that we're going to study for evaluating the convective heat transfer coefficient is by using, again, the analogy between the momentum and heat transfer. We already know this is the momentum transfer and this is the heat transfer, and we know already that there is similarities. In particular, we apply the boundary conditions. This is the final equation that we can get. We apply that pram is equal to 1, so this is exactly the same as we did in the exact analysis of the boundary layer. And we get something like this, applying the pram number. And if you remember from the nasal definition, this equation here is equal to H. So we can play around with the equation, and we finally have an introducing the skin friction coefficient. We can define the H over the density, velocity, and thermal capacity is equal to the Staton number. And this is equal to the skin friction coefficient times 2. This is the Reynolds analogy. And since we imposed in the previous step that the pram is equal to 1, this Reynolds analogy can only be applied when the pram is equal to 1. Colburn studied the same problem, but having a wider range of pram number. And he defined the Colburn J factor, which is, this is the form, this is the equation. And again, this equation can be applied with a wider range of pram number from 0.5 to 50. So as a summary, we cover in this presentation the exact analysis of the boundary layer, and this is the expression that we got for the mean heat transfer coefficient or the mean nusel. Then we also study the approximate integral analysis of the boundary layer using von Karman. This is the expression for the local nusel. And finally, we studied the Staton and the skin fraction coefficients. This is called as the Reynolds analogy. And also using the analogy between the momentum transfer and heat transfer. As already indicated, these analytical methods are convenient when the geometry is relatively easy and the conditions are specific. But we'll see that this is not very practical in terms of solving problems. That's why for many years, different researchers investigated the development of empirical equations that we will cover in the next lecture. If you have any questions, please send me an email or contact in Skype. Thank you.